Our first problem is a particle A having a charge of 2 into 10 to power minus 6 coulomb and mass of 100 gram is fixed at the bottom of a smooth inclined plane of inclination 30 degree. Where should another particle B having same charge and mass be placed on the incline so that it may remain in equilibrium? Suppose M1 is the mass and Q1 is the charge of particle A, and M2 is the mass and Q2 is the charge of particle B. Separation between these two particles is x, and Fe is the electrostatic repulsion between these two charges. Now M2G is the gravitational force which is acting in downward direction. This inclination is 30 degree. Resolving M2G into its components, one perpendicular to this plane and other component along this plane. The perpendicular component to the plane is M2G. This angle will be 30 degree. This angle will be of magnitude 30 degree. So this component, the component perpendicular to this plane, is M2G cos 30, and this component along the plane is M2G sin 30 degree. It is M2G sin 30 degree. The normal reaction of plane on the block is opposite to M2G cos 30 degree, that is normal to the plane. It is N. In equilibrium, N will be equal to M2G cos 30. And electrostatic repulsion Fe is equal to M2G sin 30 degree. The value of electrostatic repulsion is K Q1 Q2 upon X square. And M2G sin 30 is 1 upon 2. So the value of X will be square root of K Q1 Q2, 2 is also here, 2K Q1 Q2 upon M2G. Here M1 is equal to M2 is equal to 100 gram is equal to 0.1 kg, it is given. And Q1 is equal to Q2 is equal to 2 into 10 to the power minus 6 coulomb, it is also given. The value of K is 9.0 into 10 to the power 9 Newton meter square per coulomb. So the value of X will be, to substitute these values in this equation, suppose this is your equation 1. So the value of X will be 0.27 meter, that is 27 centimeter. Now the second problem is, four identical charges are fixed at the corners of a square of side A. Find electric field at point P, which is at a distance Z, lying on the line perpendicular to the plane of the square passing through the center of the square. Here ABCD is a square, and four identical charges Q, each of magnitude Q, are fixed at the corners A, B, C and D respectively. P is the point at distance Z, perpendicular distance Z, from the center of this square. This is your point P, and perpendicular distance from the center of this square is Z. This is perpendicular from P on the center of a square. It is the center of a square, suppose it is O. Let us join this point A with point C. These are diagonally opposite ends of the square. Let us join these two points. This angle is of magnitude 90 degree. This angle is also of magnitude 90 degree. Suppose the angle made by line CP with perpendicular is theta. This is theta. So this angle AP, angle made by line AP with line PO will also be theta, will also be theta. So this will also be theta. As the charge at point P is Q and it is positive, so the electric field at point P due to this charge Q at A will be in the direction of AP. Suppose it is E1, so the direction of E1 will be along AP. It is E1 in this direction. This electric field has two components. One is perpendicular to the perpendicular OZ. It is this component, and other is parallel to this perpendicular OP. This will be in this direction. Since angle APO is theta, so this angle will also be equal to theta. This angle will also be equal to theta. Now the component of E1 in this direction is E1 sin theta. E1 sin theta. And in the direction of line OP is E1 cos theta. Similarly, electric field due to charge Q at point C is E2, and E2 is in the direction of CP. This is your E2. This angle will also be equal to theta, as this angle is theta. This angle is theta. These points A and C are opposite ends of the diagonal AC. So these angles are equal. So this angle will also be theta. Now components of E2 along the along perpendicular OP is E2 cos theta. E2 cos theta. And perpendicular to the line OP, it is E2 sin theta. Now magnitude of E1 and E2 are equal. Magnitudes of E1 and E2 are equal because this distance, let this distance is R. So this distance is equal to this distance. So we can cancel E2 sin theta by E1 sin theta. Similarly, if we assume the electric fields at point P due to charges B and D, due to charges Q at B and Q at D are E3 and E4. So E3 sin theta and E4 sin theta will get cancelled. And the net charge, net electric field at point P will be E is equal to E1 cos theta plus E2 cos theta plus E3 cos theta plus E4 cos theta. E3 cos theta and E4 cos theta are the components of electric field along the line OP due to charges q at b and q at d respectively. So the net electric field is given by 4E1 cos theta as magnitudes of E1, E2, E3 and E4 are equal, because these distances are equal. These distances are equal, and E is given by K Q upon R square. So we can write E1 is equal to K Q upon R square. Now the side of this square is A, so half diagonal length will be equal to A upon root 2, and the perpendicular distance of P from center O is Z. So the distance R is given by R is equal to square root of A upon root 2 square. This distance is square plus this distance is square, because this angle is 90 degree. So we are applying Pythagorean theorem in triangle AOP. Distance AO square plus OP distance square, it is Z square. This value will be equal to A square upon 2 plus Z square root. Therefore R square will be equal to A square upon 2 plus Z square, and cos theta is equal to base upon hypotenuse. Base is Z upon R. It will be equal to Z upon square root of A square upon 2 plus Z square. Substituting these values in this equation 1, we get E is equal to 4E1 cos theta, 4E1 cos theta, 4 value of E1 is KQ upon R square, KQ, Q is Q upon R square, value of R square is this, A square upon 2 plus Z square, and the value of cos theta is Z upon A square upon 2 plus Z square root. So it will be equal to 4 K Q Z upon A square upon 2 plus Z square to whole power 3 upon 2. This is your answer. Now next problem is, two identical positive point charges each of magnitude Q are placed on x axis at x is equal to minus A and x is equal to plus A as shown in figure. Plot the variation of E along the x axis. And second question is, plot the variation of E along the y axis. In this diagram, A and B are two points at positions x is equal to minus A and x is equal to plus A respectively. The charge at point A is plus Q and also at point B it is plus q. For simplicity, we have divided the whole x-axis into three sections. This is your section first, section second, and section third. At any position in section first, the direction of electric field due to charge plus q at point A is along the positive direction of x-axis, it is EA, and due to charge plus q at this point B, it is also along positive direction of x-axis, it is EB. So the net electric field in section first is EA plus EB. At any position in section first, it is AE is equal to EA plus EB. Now, as we know that E proportional to 1 upon R square. So very far from point B on positive direction of x-axis, E will be 0. As R becomes infinite and very close to point B, the dominating charge is plus q at this point. So very close to point B, R will be 0, and so electric field E will become infinite. And now the direction of electric field is positive direction of x-axis. On graph we represent E along y-axis and distance along x-axis. So very close to point B, E is infinite and direction is along the positive direction of x-axis. So electric field will be infinite on positive side of y-axis, that is parallel to this imaginary axis. This will be your graph in section first, because 1 upon r square graph is like this. Very far from point B, the value of E is 0. So this will be parallel to x-axis. Very far from point B, the value of electric field will be 0. Now in this section third, the direction of EA and EB are along the negative direction of x-axis. Very far from point A, the net electric field will be 0, and very close to point A, the dominating charge is this plus q, and electric field will be infinite near the point A. So the graph will be like this. This is your graph. 1 upon r square graph is like this. Will be like this. As E is negative, as the direction of E is along the negative direction of x-axis, so we show it on negative side of y-axis. Very far from point A, the electric field will be 0. It is parallel to x-axis. Now in section second, the direction of EA is along the positive direction of x-axis, EA direction, and negative direction of x-axis is the direction of EB. EB is in this direction. This is the direction of EB in section second. At point O, the magnitudes of EA and EB will be equal to each other, and the directions are opposite, so net electric field at point O is 0. Here the net electric field is 0. Now very close to point A, the dominating charge is plus q at point A, and the direction is positive direction of x-axis. So we show the electric field by this graph. It is parallel to y-axis. Very close to A, the इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज पैरेलल टू वाई एक्सिस एज आर टेंस टू जीरो वेरी क्लोज टू पॉइंट ए ई बिकम्स इनफाइनाइट. सो ई इज पैरेलल टू वाई एक्सिस एंड एज वी गो फ्रॉम ए टू ओ द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड बिकम्स जीरो एंड नियर द पॉइंट बी द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड द डोमिनेटिंग चार्ज इज प्लस क्यू एट पॉइंट बी एंड डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज द नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्स एक्सिस. सो द ग्राफ इज लाइक दिस. ग्राफ इज लाइक दिस. वन अपॉन आर स्क्वायर ग्राफ बट नियर द पॉइंट बी द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज इनफाइनाइट एंड डायरेक्शन इज नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्स एक्सिस एज द डोमिनेटिंग चार्ज इज प्लस क्यू एट पॉइंट बी एंड एज वी गो फ्रॉम पॉइंट ओ टू पॉइंट बी टू ओ द डोमिनेशन ऑफ ए इंक्रीजेस वेयर एज डोमिनेशन ऑफ बी डिक्रीजेस एट पॉइंट ओ द मैग्नीट्यूड्स ऑफ ई ए एंड ई बी विल बी इक्वल टू ईच अदर बट डायरेक्शंस आर अपोजिट. सो नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट दिस पॉइंट इज जीरो. सो द ग्राफ इज लाइक दिस. दिस इज योर वेरिएशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑन एक्स एक्सिस. नाउ वेरिएशन ऑफ ई अलोंग वाई एक्सिस. लेट पी बी एनी पॉइंट ऑन वाई एक्सिस. इट इज योर वाई एक्सिस एट डिस्टेंस वाई फ्रॉम ओरिजिन ओ एंड डिस्टेंस ओ बी इज ए एंड ऑल्सो द डिस्टेंस ओ ए इज इक्वल टू ए. सो फ्रॉम पाइथागोरियन थ्योरम द डिस्टेंस पी बी विल बी इक्वल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ ए स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर सपोज इट इज आर एंड सिमिलरली द डिस्टेंस ए पी विल ऑल्सो बी इक्वल टू आर. द वैल्यू ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट पॉइंट पी ड्यू टू दिस चार्ज प्लस क्यू इज ई ए इज इक्वल टू के क्यू अपॉन आर स्क्वायर. आर इज दिस डिस्टेंस इज इक्वल टू के क्यू अपॉन ए स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर बिकॉज आर इज इक्वल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ ए स्क्वायर दिस डिस्टेंस स्क्वायर प्लस दिस डिस्टेंस स्क्वायर वाई स्क्वायर. सो आर स्क्वायर विल बी इक्वल टू ए स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर. सो ई ए विल बी इक्वल टू के क्यू अपॉन ए स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर अलॉन्ग ए पी बिकॉज दिस इज योर पॉजिटिव चार्ज. सो द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट पॉइंट पी ड्यू टू दिस चार्ज प्लस क्यू इज अलॉन्ग ए पी डायरेक्शन. दैट इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ई ए इज दिस. दिस इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ई ए. ई ए इट इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ई ए. एंड सिमिलरली द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ई बी ड्यू टू चार्ज बी ड्यू टू चार्ज प्लस क्यू एट पॉइंट बी इज अलॉन्ग बी पी. दिस इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ई बी. दिस इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ई बी. लेट दिस एंगल इज थीटा. सपोज दिस एंगल इज थीटा. नाउ द कंपोनेंट ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ई ए अलॉन्ग ओ पी इज ई ए कॉस थीटा एंड परपेंडिकुलर टू ओ पी इट इज ई ए साइन थीटा. इन दिस डायरेक्शन इट इज ई ए साइन थीटा. ई ए साइन थीटा. सिमिलरली द कंपोनेंट ऑफ ई बी अलॉन्ग ओ पी इज ई बी कॉस थीटा एंड बिकॉज ई ए कॉस थीटा एंड ई बी कॉस थीटा आर इन सेम डायरेक्शन सो नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड अलॉन्ग ओ पी विल बी ई ए कॉस थीटा प्लस ई बी कॉस थीटा एंड द कंपोनेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ई बी परपेंडिकुलर टू ओ पी इज ई बी साइन थीटा. ई बी साइन थीटा. एज मैग्नीट्यूड मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ई ए एंड ई बी आर इक्वल सो ई ए साइन थीटा विल बी इक्वल टू ई बी साइन थीटा. सो ई बी साइन थीटा गेट कैंसल्ड विद ई ए साइन थीटा. Therefore, net electric field at point P is E is equal to E A cos theta plus E B cos theta, and it is directed along the direction OP. Now, taking cos theta common from both these steps, we get E A plus E B and cos theta. From this figure, if this angle is theta, so this angle will also be equal to theta, and cos theta will be equal to, cos theta is equal to base upon hypotenuse. Base is y and hypotenuse is square root of a square plus y square. Therefore, this will be equal to EA plus EB into cos theta. Value of cos theta is y upon square root of a square plus y square. As EA is also equal to EB, therefore we can write net electric field as 2 EA y upon square root of a square plus y square. The value of EA is k q upon a square plus y square and y upon square root of a square plus y square. It will be equal to 2k q y upon 2k q y upon a square plus y square to power 3 upon 2. This is the net electric field at any position on y axis. Now we calculate the maximum value of this electric field E. For it, we differentiate E with respect to y and equate dE upon dy with 0. That is, dE upon dy equal to 0 for maximum E. Here E is this. So, differentiating it with respect to y, we get 2kq is constant, denominator differentiation of numerator, differentiation of y is 1 minus numerator, differentiation of denominator 3 upon 2 a square plus y square to power 3 upon 2 minus 1 into, again differentiating this function, we get 2y upon denominator square a square plus y square to power 3. For maximum, it is equal to 0. This implies a square plus y square to power 1 upon 2. Taking this step common from numerator, we get equal to 0. It means a square minus 2y square is equal to 0. That is, y square is equal to a square upon 2, or y is equal to plus minus a upon root 2. Now the variation of electric field E on y axis is given in this figure. From this equation, it is clear that if y is equal to 0, then E will also be equal to 0. And if E tends to infinite, then E is equal to 2k, y tends to infinite. If y tends to infinite, then E is equal to 2k limit y tends to infinite ay upon a square plus y square to power 3 upon 2 is equal to 0, because the highest power of y in denominator is greater than the highest power of y in numerator. So this value will be equal to 0. Limit y tends to infinite ay upon this will be 0. So the electric field E y graph will become parallel to y axis near infinite, and the maximum value of electric field is given at point a is equal to y is equal to a upon root 2. This is the maximum value of E. Similarly, in negative direction of y axis, the maximum value of E is at point this, that is at distance minus a upon root 2. From here y is equal to minus a upon root 2. This is the maximum value of y in negative direction of y axis. So this is your graph of variation of E along y axis. Now next problem is, find the electric dipole moment of a non-conducting ring of radius a made of two semicircular rings having linear charge densities minus lambda and plus lambda as shown in figure. To determine the net electric field of this ring, we consider an elementary part of length dl, both sides of y axis here and here. Length of this part is dl. This part is dl. So the charge on this part will be, if the charge on this part or this part is dq, then here the charge will be dq is equal to plus lambda into dl. As a is the radius of this ring and dl is this length, this arc length, so from diagram dl is equal to a is the radius of ring into d theta is the angle made by this arc of length dl at origin O, and theta is the angular position of point A from x axis. So the value of dq, elementary charge dq, is lambda a d theta. Substituting the value of this lambda here, we get lambda a d theta. Dq is equal to lambda a d theta. And the half length of this elementary dipole is a cos theta. As a is the radius and this angle is theta, so this angle will also be equal to theta. So this half length from diagram, this half length will be equal to a cos theta. So the dipole moment of this elementary dipole is dp is equal to magnitude of charge dq into the length of dipole is 2a cos theta. It will be equal to lambda a d theta into 2a cos theta. It is equal to lambda 2 lambda a square cos theta d theta. So the net dipole moment of the whole ring is P is equal to integration of 2 lambda a square cos theta d theta. The starting value of theta is minus pi upon 2. This is your angle minus pi upon 2. And the final angle is plus pi upon 2, this is plus pi upon 2, so substitute minus pi upon 2 as a lower limit and plus pi upon 2 as an upper limit, you get p is equal to 2 lambda a square cos theta d theta. It means p is equal to 2 lambda a square is constant, integration of cos theta is sin theta, lower limit is minus pi upon 2 and upper limit is plus pi upon 2. It is equal to 2 lambda a square, sin plus pi upon 2 will be equal to 1, minus sin minus pi upon 2 will be equal to minus 1. So this value will be equal to 4 lambda a square. This is required dipole moment of this non-conducting ring. Now next problem is, find the electric dipole moment of a non-conducting ring of radius a having linear charge densities lambda and minus lambda as shown in this figure. This is your ring and charge density plus lambda is here, and in this section the charge density is minus lambda. We are considering the small part of length dl here. It is of length dl and angular position of this small part is theta. Suppose the angle made by this length dl is d theta at origin O. So the elementary dipole moment of dipole formed by this charge dq and this charge minus dq is, it is minus dq. The dipole moment is dp is equal to of this elementary dipole is dp is equal to charge dq into length. Length is this radius a and this radius a. The length is 2a. So the dipole moment is 2a. Value of dq is lambda a d theta. It will be equal to twice lambda a square d theta. The direction of this dipole moment is from negative to positive charge. So let dp is the dipole moment of this elementary dipole. So the x component of this dipole moment is, elementary dipole moment is dp cos theta, and y component is dp sin theta. Net x component of dipole moment is px is equal to integration of dp cos theta. The value of theta is from 0 to pi upon 2. It will be equal to, substitute the value of dp from this equation here, you get 2 lambda a square cos theta d theta, 0 is here and pi upon 2 is here. Taking 2 lambda a square outside the integration sign, we get integration of cos theta d theta 0 to pi upon 2. It is 2 lambda a square. Integration of cos theta is sin theta, so sin pi upon 2 minus sin 0. It is equal to twice lambda a square into 1, which is equal to twice lambda a square. So px is equal to x component of dipole moment of this ring is equal to twice लेमडा ए स्क्वायर. सिमिलरली वाई कंपोनेंट ऑफ दिस डाइपोल मोमेंट इज डी पी साइन थीटा. इट इज़ योर डी पी साइन थीटा. एंड सो नेट वाई कंपोनेंट ऑफ डाइपोल मोमेंट इज इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ डी पी साइन थीटा फ्रॉम लिमिट जीरो टू पाई अपॉन टू. नाउ इंटीग्रेटिंग दिस वैल्यू वी गेट इट विल बी इक्वल टू टू लेमडा ए स्क्वायर. सो नेट डाइपोल मोमेंट पी विल बी एज पी एक्स इज इन दिस डायरेक्शन एंड पी वाई इज इन दिस डायरेक्शन. सो नेट डाइपोल मोमेंट पी इज स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ पी एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस पी वाई स्क्वायर. इट इज इक्वल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ टू लेमडा ए स्क्वायर प्लस होल स्क्वायर प्लस टू लेमडा ए स्क्वायर इट्स होल स्क्वायर. इट विल बी इक्वल टू ट्वाइस लेमडा ए स्क्वायर रूट टू.